morning, Desmond. Terrific.
Something that we want to try and get hold of, so I'm going to do that because Callum has gone off with Desmond to go swimming and he's in great form today. We've had great fun, lots of laughter this morning, so I'm about to go and buy an old Wrinkley's ticket and head off downtown on this special mission. See you later.
Right, good afternoon everybody. This morning Callum's enjoyed a lovely few hours with Desmond. They went to Desmond's house, watched a bit of Sesame Street. They then went to fill the car up with some gas and got some more groceries and then returned back to the Success Centre, where Callum is really intrigued in all the finer details. So from Desmond's clothing, he's really sort of fiddling with and then looking at with intrigue as well. And then I arrived about 11:30 and we popped in to see Dr. Musaffa, who ran some non-invasive tests on Callum. So Callum had to hold a metal pole just with one hand for about a minute or so. And that pole tested every single organ in Callum's body and its functionality and their functionality. And then he had to put every finger and his both thumbs into a little machine and rest it in there for probably five seconds maximum. And that then tested the functionality of every single cell in Callum's body and instantly produced this report that was which showed where things weren't working and where things were and what he's missing to make sure his body's functioning to the best it can be. I was intrigued. I could have listened to him for hours and hours, but we're going to wait for the report. We're going to then put everything into place that we were told to put into place. But one key thing that we could instantly see is that Callum's missing a vitamin or mineral. I can't remember the name of it. I've never heard it before. But when you look at what that vitamin or mineral does in your body, it ensures your neurological transmission is of the highest possible standard. And Callum was missing that vitamin or mineral. So there's got to be a link. There's got to be some there. So with all the work Desmond's doing, together with the NOIT, together then with the new knowledge that this non-invasive testing of Callum's internal organs and functionality, we might just be finding even more keys to help unlock Callum, because I do know it's going to be a mix of it all put together to create that perfect environment for Callum to then thrive. So we're off now to Niagara, and Callum's sitting in the middle of the car this time because Desmond spotted this morning when Callum was in his car that he wasn't too keen on not being able to see. So we've moved his seat into the middle. He's very tired this morning. He's had quite an intense time, but he's peaceful and he's calm. So we're gonna go and have a look at Niagara because we just love it there. Mummy's watch, Callum. Yeah, it is. It's pretty, isn't it? Bat Mouth is our island. Here we are on our way down to the falls via a bit of a secret passage. Callum, wait for Mummy. Here's Callum walking nice and calmly. We came here on our first or second day and we couldn't let his hand go because we didn't trust he'd stay near us. And you can see he just stays close. Nice and happy and in control. Good boy, Callum. Lovely walking.
Here we are. We've
just arrived at Niagara Falls, and this is my favourite place in Ontario, and I just think it's incredible. So we've come back, so let's get down there and explore. Here we are having our snack just in front of Niagara Falls. It's just amazing. Right, here we are walking down. We're getting a bit wet because the mist is blowing in. In our direction. Good boy, Callum. I've been waiting to see a rainbow, and there it is.
Here.
Cal!